Cannon Beach is one of Oregon's most iconic and popular beaches. But Mark Ward and his crew aren't here on vacation.
Look at this. There's so much under there.
They're here to clean up.
You want to go ahead and run it again?
You want to run it with me, Carrie? This is what we love. Just the most pure sand. This is pristine. This is what you want to sit in.
Unfortunately, sand doesn't look this way all by itself. At least not anymore.
All beaches have microplastics now. There was your coffee cup. What's left of it? Now it's food for some marine organism.
Microplastics are the tiny particles that make up larger plastic items. They're also what's left when those larger plastics break down. To marine life, these small suspended particles look a lot like food. In 2002, Mark founded Sea Turtles Forever to protect the endangered animals.
One of the most important aspects of marine turtle conservation is habitat. So I started studying degradation of habitat. And as we were working on that, they were starting to lose a lot of sea turtles in Australia. And we were seeing microplastics in every single necropsy. Shortly after that, we had 100 sea turtles stranded in Brazil. And what they found in the necropsy was thousands of microplastics that they had ingested.
When 13-pound turtle had swallowed more than 3,500 pieces of plastic.
Microplastic might be the most significant threat to the long-term sustainability of marine turtles.
Researchers knew that microplastics were killing turtles, but suspected there was more to the story.
Plastics have the ability to absorb persistent organic pollutants from the ocean and the worst chemicals we ever made. PCBs, PBDE, DDT, were all contained in these microplastics now.
These persistent organic pollutants, known as POPs, have been linked to neurological defects in children and cancer.
At that point, I realized it's basically feeding toxic substance to our entire marine food web every day.
That also includes humans who eat that seafood.
I realized that we had to develop some kind of system to remove the microplastics.
Mark came up with a lightweight, low-cost screen to systematically filter microplastics from the beach sand.
We've set up a 1 square meter grid so that we can gauge the density of microplastics in the beach.
The teams have found everything from hypodermic needles to the remains of shotgun shells to thousands of tiny pellets called nurdles.
For manufacturing plastics.
As discouraging as the results were, Mark's screen was effective.
It actually worked way better than we ever imagined. Not only can we do large areas of beach relatively fast, but because it's a polymer mesh screen, we found it generates a low static charge. And we discovered that we were collecting plastic dust with that screen that you can't even see in the beach. Particles the size of a grain of sand. That was a big bonus. Okay, now we gotta make sure we get everything, every bit of this dust, all this stuff, because we're gonna analyze the sand too.
The data collected by the group's painstaking surveys are part of a variety of research and conservation projects, all targeting plastic pollution. Recent innovations, like the System One Ocean Cleanup Project, to catch plastic before it gets to shore, are underway. But the press was quick to point out that this effort didn't live up to its promise.
The majority of plastics are subsurface. There's no technology out there that's going to remove that plastic without doing potentially great harm to the marine food web, because you're going to be harvesting a lot more than the plastics. So when it comes to the beach, we have an opportunity. Oh, there's one of those nurdles I was talking about. It's industrial pellets. They go into a plastic injection mold, and you get your sunglasses or your car parts. That's the raw material that makes all plastics. And there are billions upon billions of these in the ocean now. So many polymer pellets in this load.
Mark, this is so bad.
Yep. This beach needs a full cleanup. This year in Cannon Beach, we've probably taken a ton, you know, just in Cannon Beach. In one day at Fort Stevens, we took 550 pounds. You know, it's on that kind of a scale.
Multiply that by all the beaches in the world, and the problem can seem insurmountable. That point is not lost on Mark Ward.
You know, it's really bad. It's bad everywhere. It's not just here. There's no end to this issue in our lifetimes, our kids' lifetimes. But I have to keep a positive attitude. We have shipped hundreds of screens all over the world. So there's thousands of people filtering now. And the other thing is, you don't filter the whole beach. The microplastics are all in a band, maybe 5 to 10 meters wide. The bulk of the material will be in that high tide rack line. We don't have filter down there. Thank God, that would be impossible. And we're removing several tons of microplastic with our crew right here every year. But that's not enough. Our use of plastic is completely out of hand. Plastic things wrapped in plastic, encased in plastic. Any way you can get away from using plastic is a benefit. This is not the ultimate solution, filtering these beaches and doing our work, but we're a vital part of the solution.
I'll grab the shovels.
And I look at the beautiful sand we just created as I move forward 1 meter at a time. Gotta focus on the good.